Hello everyone, and welcome to another Company Heroes 2 Replay Cast. My name is ATR, and today we're gonna have ourselves a 1v1 Ankolodny Ferma Winter. Our heroes today are going to be Storm Tiger Sage 6, also known as Sage of the Six, playing as the Soviet forces in the blue. And his opponent, in characters alien to my language, we have the red opponent as the Ostir or Wehrmacht faction. I look at the name in the forums that it pulls, it just says /MXX percentage sign question, but well, obviously these are some characters in a different language. I'm not even going to try and guess which language it is, because that's probably going to be offensive in some way, so we'll just leave it at that. So, first engagement of the game, up in the northern fuel, we got Sage of the Six sending his conscripts to cap, getting some heavy cover, as the red player sends his Pios into the shack. Gonna be holed up there, prolonging the engagement, but we do have an MG42 on the field, as of course I'll mention a couple times until it is no longer necessary. You can go back to the HQ now. Starts getting some shots off on the conscript when the conscript Ura away, managing to stave off the suppression, dancing around the point, and finally being able to get the point cap. Get themselves behind the house, losing one of its men to the Pio Squad's SMGs, but managing to stave off the suppression and the damage of the MG42. And, well, it's now going to be able to take the point, or keep the point. Pios pop out of the house, MG42 popping into the house, and that will be all for now. Back at base, we see that the Ostir player has gone for tier 1, getting Grenz, 2 Grenz to be exact, which seems to be the same old standard, you know, Grenz and MG opening, but the order in which they come out, you know, has changed simply because of the Tekken situation. You get your Pios to start building tier 1, you get the MG42 getting built while it's getting out, so MG comes out first. Sandbags getting laid down in an excellent position there for Sage of the Six. Almost cuts off the entire approach, getting heavy cover all over the place. But it is getting engaged by 2 Grand Squads, so that means that it will lose the engagement. We also hear an MG shooting at something? What was that? Well, I don't know. But the conscripts are going to lay up at the top as they engage against the Grands, but they will lose, and there they go, so they end up retreating. MG42 getting some shots at it on the side will set up to try and catch it on the retreat. Could potentially pick up 1 or 2 kills here. I don't think it'll clean up the squad. There goes the burst. One burst doing a lot of damage. Down to 2 men. Oh, the Pios may actually finish up the squad here. More bursts continue to go on. The men getting caught in the way. SMGs now losing their functionality at range. 2 men continue to stay alive, and Sage manages to keep his squad alive. Sage of the Six, for his part, has gone for conscripts. Blech. Can't even say that 2 times fast. Or 3 times at that. But yeah, 4 conscripts on the field for Sage. Pretty standard, I suppose. And as we see these conscripts engaging, Ooh, nice. He's getting engaged by 2 Grand Squads, but they Ura away into the house. Nice liberal use there of Ura for Sage of the Six, not being too conservative with his munitions. He knows that that speed buff can come into effect even if you're not going to use it throughout the entire run. Like up here, we see Sage Uraing to get on top of the sandbags, managing to get that cover there and push away the Pio Squad. Pio Squad does make it out of which 2, but now there's a Grand Squad that will engage. The sandbags will not help him out. He actually was building a second sandbag, apparently. And the conscripts retreat as they want to get themselves healed up and reinforced. Back at base, we do see medics on the field for Sage, so he wants to have his infantry at the best fighting condition as possible. And we see the Ostir player going for 4 Grenz, so dedicating a lot into his tier 1. He's now going to be teching up. We see battle phase 1 going down. Well, being researched, I suppose, is the proper term. But yeah, we'll see if he ends up going for tier 2 or skipping all the way through 3. Mortar getting produced as well, so heavy investment in tier 1. Conscript squad getting surrounded in all directions, not getting really much of a benefit there for those sandbags. Down to 1 man, almost loses its life, but stays alive and makes it out of there. Southern portion of the map, however, is completely captured. Sage, he is in fact even building a munitions cache on the cutoff point. a very vulnerable munitions cache, but it will allow Sage of the Six enough time to react if anybody wants to come and you know, cut off the southern resources, which they wouldn't be able to regardless because of the center point already being capped. But still, you know, gives you that time, also gives him the munitions, which means he can Ura to his heart's content. Mine's getting laid down in the center road. Nice placement there. You know, it's always a good thing to mine the roads whenever possible. Conscript sitting in the front of the base, just guarding that point, and we see that the Ostia player is just concentrating on the north. Wire getting laid down across the path there, making sure that all units have to go in this direction. And the conscripts push forward, getting themselves on top of the Grens. The Grens on top, well, it's 2 versus 1. They just manhandle that conscript squad and force it to retreat, and the second squad is also taking quite a bit of damage, down to 3 men, another squad behind it, and 5 man strong trying to hold the line, but against 3 Grens, they're not going to survive. Rifle grenade goes off, going to get a nice hit there. Oh, conscript squad taking a nasty blow, down to 4 men, and forces the retreat. Sage is forced to abandon the north and concede it to the Austere faction. Center and south of the map, not much going on. We see a Pyo squad going to be poking and prodding, going to run into that conscript squad. Could potentially cap the map, not the map, the point. But no, it looks like teching is going to be taking place. We see more mortars. Actually, no, a mortar getting produced again. So I didn't check that or see that, but it got canceled. It was being built a little while ago. Looks like he canceled it for some reason or another, and I guess to build tier 2. Tier 2 has gone down, but nothing is being produced from that. Not entirely sure why. I guess he was expecting some type of vehicle play, maybe? Guards on the field for Sage of the Six. He has the guard rifle combined arms tactics. Again, a doctrine that we had not seen used in a long while, has been seeing a lot of play in this patch. Why, I don't precisely know. There's nothing too special about it, but, you know, it's always been a decent selection. I suppose now that, you know, the call-in meta is not meta, meta is not it's not so prevalent. I suppose that's why, you know, instead of going to try and get, you know, maybe if you wanted guards, you're gonna go and get ISUs in the later game. You would only be able to field one, so maybe that makes it feel like it's not that viable or that good of a strategy. So, yeah. Again, like I said, there's nothing wrong with the doctrine. It was kick-ass back in the day. What we don't see, though, is conscripts hitting the dirt anymore, which is kind of sad. I always like them dragging that face through the dirt. Center map, we see a bit of an attempt of a push here by this Austere player, not bearing many fruits. Conscript squad does get eliminated inside the house, however, as the guards jump over the wall, apparently attempting to go into the house, but realizing, well, it's getting mortared, so that means it's going to be collapsing rather soon, so may as well not do that. Conscript laying down some sandbags all over the place. Oh, I see what he's doing. That is very, that's very cheeky there of Sage of the Six. Very, a nice trick. I wasn't entirely aware why he was doing that. By placing another sandbag in front of the other one and not building it, you're denying the heavy cover on the other side, much like wire would. So yeah, that's actually quite ingenious. Northern part of the map, we see Sage, oh, finally utilizing Hit the Dirt. Very, very cool. That doesn't give him any buff right now, but it does, I suppose, give him more accuracy per se, as all the guys are not, you know, focusing on moving, they're just attacking. He is behind the sandbag, so he still gets the benefit of the heavy cover. Conscript spot on the flank does get mortared and exploded, so it's forced to run away. Right hand side, conscript's capturing the point, but yeah, like his little trick right there, it means that they can't get the sandbag on the other side, so. It's cool, it's kind of cool. I like that. Can easily get destroyed, obviously, but you know, in an engagement, you would either have to focus on destroying the sandbag that's not built, or, well, not get to the cover. So the conscripts up in the north, they're going to lose the engagement regardless, because, you know, their conscripts are also getting mortared. Down to 2 men, could actually do with retreating now. Yeah, there they go. Grens are going to try and get some extra shots there as they retreat, and they have to run through the heavy snow. Could lose one more guy. Nope, rounds the corner, stays alive. There's an MG42 looking at it, however, taking some shots at the retreating unit. Down to 1 man. Can he make it out? Yes, he can. There's a lot of guys still. Now getting suppression going on the conscript spot in the north. Guards closing the distance. Guards do have grenades. Could throw it out and make the MG42 exit. Combat units with flamethrowers coming up on the flank. Gonna get a nice flame burst going into the house. Gets itself behind, in fact, being able to provide as much damage as possible. MG42 opening up on the guards. The guards are forced to retreat. Flamethrower burst goes off. MG42 down to two men. MG42 turning around, trying to focus on the combat engineers. Combat engineers just playing ring around the house, doing as much damage as they can. MG42 taking quite a bit of damage, down to one man. Can it actually make it out of there alive? The combat engineers could potentially kill it off. There goes the burst. MG42 now playing itself ring around Rosie, or the housey, and manages to make it out of there. Grand Squad also potentially able to get the kill there, but as the blizzard hits, the line of sight gets obscured, and the combat engineer squad barely makes it out of there. Tier 3 now down for Sage of the Six, gets himself a SU-76. SU-76 being complete badasses now, and now you can get them earlier with Tier 3, I suppose. Although, considering that before you didn't need Tier 3 for Tier 4, maybe it's not that earlier. I mean, we're already 11 minutes into the game, so it's not an SU-76 rich by any means. Pack gun getting produced for the Austere player. He is now up to 5 grand squats in total. Very, very heavy investment in that tier 1. Mortar in play, MG42 as well. And, well, I mean, really only utilizing that tier 2 for a pack gun. Not sure if it's worth it, I mean. Hasn't selected a doctrine, so, you know, who knows what his exact plan in the build order is. But, I mean, could have just as well gone for a Panther 4. This point, 113 fuel already in stock, you know, not building tier 2 and such, you know. But it's always good to have that tier 2 for the packs, you know, in case you are getting rushed by tanks. But there we go. So SU-76 up in the north, throwing a barrage at the shack here, collapsing it completely. The MG-42s and Pios, and then nothing was in there, so nothing got crushed beneath the roof, but at least the house is no longer usable. Grand Squad in the north getting chased down by conscripts with PPS Aegis. Mortar also noticing that they're going to get caught in the way, so they retreat. And the conscripts Ura forward, getting themselves on top of that point. Pack gun moving in that direction for some reason or another. Going to get shot up there by the SMGs. Putting the pack gun in a more vulnerable position, I suppose. Grants and Pios rushing to its aid. The conscripts hitting dirt. Very wise hitting the dirt there because they do not have the benefit of the heavy cover against the enemies that are shooting at them. However, the Grand Squad gets upgraded with G43s as we finally see the Doctrine selection, and that is the Elite Troops Doctrine for the Austere player. Getting those G43s on the Grands, which is very nice. But with a second squad coming up for a flank, those PPS Aegis do a lot of damage to the Grands and force their retreat. Down to 3 men on each of the squads, so it basically is one conscript squad, although considering the amount of PPS Aegis, well, that kind of makes it almost like a shock troop squad, right? How many PPS Aegis did you get with the package? 3 or 4? 3. Okay. So yeah, basically, that's a six men with PPS Aegis. Very deadly up close, but, well, they run into 2 grand squads. Take a lot of damage, forced to retreat. They'll make it out, but it happens. Conscript in the front, getting pinned down by the MG42. If they had hit the dirt before the suppression had gone off, they would have been able to stay there and continue to shoot back and not get pinned. Still, though, probably not ideal. Nice barrage going off on the MG, getting a hit, but only splash damage. Second hit, oh, misses completely. Pack gun moves up to take a shot. Second barrage, or well, third shot goes off from the artillery barrage and the SU-76 GTFOs. Combat engineers in the middle of Grens, not having too good a time here. They're gonna get assaulted by more Grens and stuff, so down to one man. Can they actually make it out alive, or is it too late for them? Well, Grens are gonna focus them down, and down it goes. Yeah. It's a little bit too late. Combat engineer squad down for Sage of the Six. Sage of the Six is down to only 2 conscripts. Going to be replacing his combat engineers as there is no other way to repair. And a mine gets hit there by the pack gun. However, it only kills 1 man. So it's a very lucky hit there for the Austere player. Munitions cache going to get targeted down here by the pack gun. So allowed Sage of the Six to keep his point for a little bit longer, but it will be lost. We do see conscripts and the SU-76 rushing forward, so they might be able to save it. Halfway point? No, they're going to stop the fight at range, so it does not look like they're going to be able to stop the cutoff. Center point has been cut off as well, so the southern resources are now cut off for Sage of the Six, and the Austere player is making quite a bit of a comeback as well. He does have that ace that can come into play later on. It is 17 command points, and we're only at 8, so it's going to be a while. Conscripts engaging the Grenz. Nice little flank here. The SU-76 throwing a barrage, getting some hits on the Pios, forcing the retreat of all the squads, and the Conscripts will be recovering the point, hitting the dirt, making sure that they have some light cover in the process, but they are getting mortared as well. Down to two men, forces a retreat, Conscript squad hitting the dirt behind the car. Again, one of those things that doesn't really help you out that much because it no longer stacks as it once did. However, However, you know, if somebody comes up on the flank where it would no longer be getting the benefit of the heavy cover, you would still have that light cover. So, you know, there's nothing wrong with that. Unless you leave them hitting the dirt and get rifle grenaded or run over by some type of vehicle, there's nothing wrong with hitting the dirt as often as possible. It's free. Sandbags starting to lay down in the center there for Sage of the Six as he tries to cap the center munitions point. SU-76 are behind them to support, so they're actually quite well. We do have that mortar still barraging into the center. 10 kills to the mortar, very nice. Better than 2-1 acquired. And Grenz move up to the north as we have guards, well, guarding the northern point. They do have DP light machine guns, so they are able to provide a decent amount of DPS against infantry. And the PTRS rifles are not bad at all. But there's a lot of infantry surrounding them. They need to retreat now. They do. Maybe a little bit too late, though. Having to run very slowly through the snow, getting caught in the tracks, down to 4 men. Can they make it out of there? Well, 2 Grenz squads are no longer able to shoot, the third one no longer able to shoot, so yeah, he's gonna make it out of there. Decent retreat there. SU-76s getting some barrages going across the fence here. Pack gun getting cleared out by one of them. We do have the second pack gun turning its sights on the SU-76s. Could shoot through the map, but it needs to be told to shoot because I don't think it can actually shoot by itself since it doesn't have line of sight. And yeah, they back off. They're still alive. And the north is going to be once again quickly recovered here by the austere player as he has, well, Grenz for days, right? Artillery gun getting built back at base for Sage of the Six. Pretty good. What's the range on that? It can reach all the way into the base, yeah. Just barely, it's at maximum range, but it could actually potentially reach into the base. Could set up Sage of the Sixth in a position where if he forces a mass retreat, he could artillery into the base for free and get a hit in there. So we'll see. Raj is actually getting targeted, but where is that flying? Into the center. So the artillery gun makes itself known. A lot of artillery firepower right now for Sage of the Six, and he does have those barrages on the SU-76s, and then on top of that from the base, so yeah. The sandbags got blown to hell there. But the Grenz have managed to capture the center point. Up in the north, we see conscripts hitting the dirt in the middle of nowhere. Guards capturing the northern victory point. Victory points are 424 for Sage of the Six, 153 for the austere player, so Sage doing quite a bit of work there. What is hitting here? Is that the SU-76s? Yeah. SU-76s barraging in the southern victory point, managing to force a retreat. And the guards and conscripts around in the north are going to be in the trouble there as they engage a Grenz squad. Grenz squad could get focused down here, down to 2 men. Could he get the kill? Well, second Grenadier squad retreated as he didn't want to accidentally leave the wrong squad there. And the conscripts hold at 3 men. Took quite a beating, but they're still alive. So Sage really just needs to put the pressure on the victory point and he can win the game by that. Sending combat engineer squad down there. When did I give that a hotkey? Huh. Oh, that's weird. Maybe I was trying to select this guy? Yeah, we'll do that. Just want to check. So the artillery gun throwing a barrage. Oh, into the base. Almost actually worked out. There was a lot of units back at base retreating. We actually see them moving back, which is kind of weird. We have taken it. But it looks like they dodged. It was hitting around. Oh, nice, nasty hit there to the bunker. Could actually take down the bunker. Oh. Nice hit there, actually killing one of the infantry there. Medic bunker, very low in health.
We are losing a sector.
Even the base sector, the base HQ building is taking some hits. And there we go. We see the Ulster player now finally moving out as he reinforces his troops. And Sage is just laying down, is just laying down some mines all over the place, which is very good. Something you should do as often as you can. Mines are good. Mine as much as you can. Until your opponent gets sweepers in that group. Grant's pushing forward. Guard's gonna get killed here. They actually drop a DP light machine gun. They're gonna retreat and get killed as well. Oh, nasty hit there by the SU-76, eliminating an entire Grant squad. Could potentially give this guard squad a fighting chance at living. The Grants are they're focusing fire on it. Down it goes. And the Grants are gonna go for the steal of a DP light machine gun. So that's a very nice gift there for the austere player. And yeah, that was a nice hit there by the SU-76, however, eliminating an entire Grant squad in one blow. 4 kills to this one, 9 kills to this one. I'm going to assume this was the guy that actually nailed the hit. Third SU-76 on the field, the fourth one getting produced. Wow, Sage of the Six just going to be spamming those onto the field. We see a Panzer IV getting built for the Austere player as he got his tier 3 up. Med Bunker did get fully repaired, or well, is getting fully repaired here as the artillery gun is currently focusing up in the north. Grant's just taking a lot of damage all over the place. They're just down to 3 Grant squads. I'm not sure if one got killed here. Doesn't look like it. Artillery shots flying all over the place. Conscript squad hold up in some green cover there. Green cover gets destroyed, but at least they still have yellow cover because of his... because they're punching the dirt. Mortar getting some shots off in there. Artillery barrage going off at the pack gun. Can it actually get the hit? Well, the mortar got a hit on the conscript squad. Nice hits there by the SU-76s. Down to 2 men on that AT gun. Oh, a nice hit, and down goes the AT gun. Does manage to get a shot off there on that SU-76. SU-76 getting picked off there by the Panzer IV, or was it the second pack gun? Might have been the second pack gun. Well, that's infantry, so yeah, it was Panzer IV. Panzer IV getting one vehicle destroyed. But we do still have 3 SU-76s, which I'm not sure if the Ulster player is aware of. So, not that big a deal for Sage, I suppose. Down to very low amounts of infantry, though. Only 1 conscript squad on the field to fight with, which is not good. And a combat engineer that I suppose could also cap. Grand squad and Panzer Grenadiers getting built for the Austere player to bolster his troops, making sure he keeps that manpower low. And the Panzer IV up in the north is just sitting on a fuel point, staring at the wrong insignias in the flag, right? Although, does it actually have any insignia? That's it's just a blue flag. Do the decals that you can put, do they actually apply to flags, maybe? That would be kind of cool. Whatever. So anyways, conscript squad holds itself up in the church, making sure it's got good line of sight and a nice roof above their heads while the blizzard goes off. Decide to abandon it as they go pushing forward to the point. Do get themselves into some, nice light cover and near the fire, so they're not going to suffer from the from the game stuttering. They're not going to suffer from the cold. They are getting themselves shut up here as they are sitting in front of the enemy building sandbags. Not exactly ideal. The sandbag does not get completely placed. They end up decapping the point, but not capping it. And the SU-76s will be throwing some more barrages as they can. Panzer IV pushing forward. Panzer IV going to run into those SU-76s. SU-76s are 4 at a time. They're going to be able to get some nice shots there on the Panzer IV. The Panzer IV can return fire and do some damage, but the SU-76s are just too many, too strong. Shots continue to fly. Panzer IV down to about half health, but the pack guns will prove to be the bigger threat here. Unfortunately, the barrages do have cooldown, so they can't just, you know, do it again. Artillery barrage going down into the center. Could potentially hit everything here. Pack guns do manage to get away. Oh no! Actually, the artillery gun managing to nail one of the pack guns. Clears off one. Second one still alive. Pios laying down some teller mines in the center as the mortar is forced to retreat. But the point did get capped. And on the northern side of the map, we see the Grand Squad with the stolen DP light machine gun capturing the victory points. 48 points left for the Austere player. Sage of the Six can almost taste victory, but he knows that it needs a little bit more time. Needs to try to control the map. SU-76 is moving up. going to be trying to push off those Grens. The Grens do manage to cap the point. The Grens could potentially throw a Faust and get some damage going. They will do that. Will they get the crit? They do get the crit as the Faust manages to inflict sufficient damage. But the Grens squad itself gets completely annihilated as the PPS Aegis do a lot of damage up close. MG42 set up right there. SU-76 is taking some shots at it, but the Panzer IV is still there. 15 command points acquired. Getting very close to that Tiger Ace. We'll see if that ends up turning the game completely for Sage. Conscript squad up in the north, down to one man, forced to retreat. It is the only combat troop currently available. At least the only one with veterans. Here we have another guard squad on the field, but it instantly gets pinned down there by the MG-42. Not going to be able to cap anything. And with incendiary shots flying in his direction, he's forced to quickly retreat or die. Grant's pushing forward. The SU-76s could potentially get some shots going. Oh, nice barrage. Oh, double nice barrage. Getting some very nice hits in there. The Grant squads do manage to get themselves past those arcs of fire. Gonna get some Faust going on the SU-76s. Potentially getting a kill there, but forces the retreat of another one. One left. Pack gun sets up right on front of the base. Gonna catch one SU-76 and down it goes. Actually getting abandoned there. Guard squad, not guard squad, Grant squad trying to go for the cap, but it can't. It's a one man squad. Does not have enough men to man a vehicle. And the pack gun decides to just detonate the enemy ordnance. And GTFO. Down south, Pilots are capturing a point. We do have a demo charge on the field for Sage, but they are not anywhere near it, so it's not going to have any effect. And the artillery gun seems to be throwing another barrage up into the north, trying to catch something in the center field, apparently. But nothing is getting caught there. SU-76s, still three in total, going to be moving up. Panzer IV has taken some damage. It's down to about half health, but it is supported by two pack guns, so that is a very difficult kill. We'll see what ends up happening. Set our map, conscripts pushing forward. Combat engineers moving around to the center. These conscripts are going to go to the south and try to recover the point. Looks like they're going to be able to do so. A demo charge did get detonated down here, but I don't think anybody was near it. We see no bodies and anything, and I frankly don't think it's important to look at it. If it had gotten a kill of some squad or another, yeah, sure. But no, it looks like nothing happened there. Mortar cleared off up in the north. We see the strafing run coming down, the IL-2 Sturmovik. Get some shots going on the Panzer IV. Panzer IV now down to about 25% strength. The SU-76s could push and get the kill. It's currently unsupported as the pack guns are moving around. However, there is no infantry in front of them right now. Well, it actually does have the guards to let them know. Artillery barrage is going down by the SU-76s. The pack guns almost running themselves into it. And the Sturmovik is still loitering. Gonna get some more shots going on the Panzer IV. No, it actually goes for the AT guns. Down go the AT guns. The Panzer IV is completely exposed. There is nothing up there to support it. We do have the Tiger Ace now on the field for the austere player. Will this be the ace in the hole? Literally? Well, actually, there's no hole here, but SU-76s move up, get some shots going. Down goes the Panzer IV. Pack gun getting recovered there by a guard squad. But the Tiger is just gonna melt these SU-76s. SU-76s getting some good shots in there. And SU-76 coming up behind the Tiger. Tiger popping some smoke. SU-76 is behind it, so it'll be able to get some shots. They all move into the smoke, making sure that they can't get targeted. And the pack gun takes a shot. Oh, the Tiger Ace is in a very bad spot here. Hasn't been able to kill enough or quickly enough. Pack gun whiffs its shot. The SU-76 behind now getting targeted by the Tiger. Faust will probably be going off. The Tiger now backing off. Oh, shot flies from the SU-76. Down goes the Tiger, and with that, I think any hope for victory for the austere player goes down and immediately throws in the towel. A little bit too bold there. The Tiger is pretty good, but I mean, going up against four SU-76 at a time and then, you know, not even having the support of your own pack guns, yeah, could have probably just waited, although victory points would have probably been bled quickly, so I guess he felt the desperation. But anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed the game. If you have any positive or negative remarks, go ahead and leave them in the comment section below. If you have any replays you want to send me, go ahead and send them to the email that I will put in the description. But otherwise, I hope you guys have a great day. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.